गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे एक्सरसाइज 13.4। इन दिस एक्सरसाइज देर आर वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स, मीन्स थ्रू स्टेटमेंट वी विल मेक द इक्वेशन, आफ्टर दैट वी विल सॉल्व दोज इक्वेशन। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड टू नंबर्स हुज सम इज 55 एंड डिफरेंस इज 77। मीन्स देर आर टू नंबर्स हुज सम इज 55। सो वी डोंट नो दैट टू नंबर्स, but we know that both the numbers sum we will get equal to 55. So let the one number or first number be x. Suppose first number is x, then the other number will be equal to what? Other number will be equal to 55 minus x, because both number sum is equal to 55. Okay. So now we know that the difference of these two number is 7. According to question, difference of these two number is 7. X is greater than this because sum of both is equal to 55 and this is less than 55. So this is smaller number and this is bigger number. So that's why I kept it first. Now open the bracket. X plus x. 2x minus 55 is equal to 7. So 2x is equal to 7 plus 55. So 2x is equal to 7 plus 5, 12. Carry 1, 62. And x is equal to 62 by, this will come and divide. So 2, 3, 6, 2, 1, x is equal to 31. Okay. First one of the number is 31. Now you have to find out the other number. Okay. One number is equal to 31. Other number is equal to 55 minus x. In this we will put the value of x. 55 minus 31 will be equal to what? 4, 5 minus 3, 24. One number is 24, other number is 31. Make it sum, it will be equal to 55 only. 31 plus 24. Got it? Now question number 2. Half of a number exceeds 1/4 of it by 9. Means we don't know what is the number. So first of all, we will let the number be x. What is written? Half of a number. So half of a number I have written exceeds 1/4 of it. It will exceeds 1/4 of that number by, exceed means increasing. Okay, by 9. 9 will be added to it. Now how to solve this? 1 by 2 minus 1 by, this will come this side, it will come in minus, 9 will be remain here only. Now take the LCM, we will get 4 as LCM. 2 2 4 minus 4 1 4, we will get x only. Okay, 2x minus x will be equal to x. So x is equal to 9 into, this is in divide, it will go this side, it will come in multiply. 9 4s are 36. So 36 is that number which we have let x. Understood? Now question number 3. Question number 3 is the sum of 3 consecutive odd number is 105. 3 consecutive means continuous number. Okay. So the sum of 3 consecutive odd number is equal to 105. So what is that 3 consecutive numbers? 3 continuous number but odd number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If I will write counting like this, can you tell me what are odd numbers? Suppose here we can say that 1 is a odd number. Yes. 3 is a odd number. 5 is a odd number. 7 is a odd number. 9 is a odd number. So how odd number is coming? Just one after the other means alternate. Okay. 1 after that 2. 2 is not an odd number. It is an even. After that 3 is an odd number. 4 is not odd number. Alternatively it is coming. Odd numbers are coming alternatively. But you have to take 3 continuous odd number. So if you will take this 3 continuous odd number, but we don't know what are that odd numbers exactly. We have to find out. So we will let the 3 consecutive odd numbers is equal to, one is suppose x, the other will be equal to x plus 1. No. Because if suppose x is 1, then 1 plus 1 will be equal to what? 2. And 2 is not a odd number. So we will have to take x plus 2. So that 1 plus 2 equal to 3. Okay. Then x plus what? 3? No. 3 will be equal to 3 plus 1, 4. So we will not take 3. We will take alternate numbers we will add. We will add here 4. 1 is x. The other odd number is x plus 2. And the other third one is x plus 4. These are the three consecutive odd number. And according to question, it is written x, sum of these odd numbers is equal to 105. Okay. Now we will add this. We have added x plus x plus x will be equal to 3x. 4 plus 2 will be equal to 6. Yes. Now 3x is equal to 105. This is in plus. It will come this side. It come in minus. Okay. Now 105 minus x, it will be equal to 99. Okay. Now x is equal to 99 by 3. It is in multiply. It will come here in divide. 3 3 is a 9. 3 3 is a 9. X is equal to 33. So first odd number is 33. Now next odd number will be equal to x plus 2. That is 33 plus 2 is equal to 35. And the other is x plus 4. So 33 plus 4. That is equal to 37. So these are the three continuous odd number. Yes or no? 33, after that 35, and after that 37. 34 is not an odd number. So we will not write that one. Okay. These are the three consecutive odd numbers. Now question number 4. The age of a father is thrice his son's age. We don't know what is the father age. We don't know what is the son's age. But age of father is 3 times his son's age. Suppose son's age is x. Then father age will be 3x. Because thrice means 3 times. Okay. If half of father age exceeds half of son's age by 22 years. Look at here. First of all we will let the son's age be x. So father's age will be equal to what? Father's age will be equal to 3x because father is thrice of the son's age. And if half of father's age, if half of what is father's age? 3x. So it's half we will do. If half of father's age exceeds half of son's age, this is half of son's age, it is exceeding by 22. Find the percentage of father and son both. So first of all we will solve this equation. X by 2 will plus 22. Then 3x by 2 minus x by 2. This x we will bring this side. So that variable will come one side. Okay. Take the LCM. 3x minus x is equal to 22. This is equal to 2x by 2 is equal to 22. Then 2 will get cancelled. We will get x is equal to 22. One of the x means x age is son's age. So son's age is 22. What is the father's age? Father's age will be equal to 3x. So 3 into 22. X value is 22, no? That's why 66 years is the father's age and 22 years is the son's age. Clear? Now question number 5. Divide 80 mangoes between x and y. Suppose x and y are two boys or two girls, anybody. Okay, we have to divide 80 mangoes between these two. So that x gets 14 mangoes more than y. Means x will get 14 more mangoes than y. But we have only total number of mangoes is 80. So let y get number of mangoes be x. Suppose y got x mangoes. Okay. Y got x mangoes. Then x will get how many mango? X will get. Therefore x will get. X plus. This one. X plus 14 mangoes. Because x is getting 14 mangoes more than y's mango. Now we know total number of a mango is 180. So number of mangoes both x and y, they have got x plus 14 is equal to 80. That is equal to total number of mangoes, and this is also total number of mangoes. Now solve it. X plus x, 2x. This 14 we will bring this side. 80 minus 14, 10 minus 4, 6, 7 minus 1, 6. So x is equal to 66 by 2. 2, 3 is 6, 2, 3 is x is equal to 33 mangoes. X mangoes is whose? Y. So y will get 33 mangoes. So x will get how many mangoes? X will get 14 mangoes more than y. 33 plus 14. 47 mangoes x will get. Now you add 47 plus 33 will be equal to 80 mangoes total. Okay. This is the way you have to solve it. Now question number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You have to try it. Okay. Like the perimeter of rectangle is 126 meter. If its length is given, length is 5 meter more than its breadth. Suppose breadth is x, then length will be x plus 5, because length is 5 meter more than breadth. Length is this, breadth is this. Find the sides of the rectangle. Perimeter is given. So perimeter of rectangle is equal to what? Twice of L plus B will be equal to, perimeter is given, 126 we can write. Now put the value of L here, x plus 5, put the value of breadth, that is x. Okay, then solve it and find out the length and breadth. Question number 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is your homework. If you will not be able to solve, then only I will explain. But first you have to try. Okay.